Well, this is awkward. Hello everybody, welcome back to GTA 5. I know, I said I was done. It's been like a month and a half now. That's a lot. But apparently, I have more time than I thought I would, so let's terrorize the city a little bit more, shall we?
Come with me now. Come with me now.
That's a really big drop. Holy crap. Yeah, that's not how a braking system is supposed to function. Yeah. And let's start off with Obey. A few years ago, in 2013, they released this, the 9F. And it was unequivocally a masterpiece. It even came in a convertible, which means when you lower the roof down, you could still hit over 180 miles an hour. And then they followed that up with the guts of that sports car and shoved it into their four-door sedan, the Tailgater. This was a much more practical, much more logical vehicle for the family to own. It has four doors, it's very comfortable, it's a mid-sized sedan, so it fits in parking spaces. And it can also do that. That is some serious speed for a sedan. I'm in love. I really am. However, as great as the 9F and the Tailgater were, they were still missing one market. Until now. Right, it's called the 8F, I know, very original, these Germans, I can't believe it. And it's supposedly very quick. Oh, I'm not wrong, 0 to 60, that's 3.5 seconds, holy crap. Alright, there we go, there's 100, 120, and a flat out top speed of 155. Jesus Christ, this is quick. Oh. Bloody hell, fire! That's alarming for a two-door coupe. Oh, oh, oh. Now if I want to do a proper comparison, a proper test of this vehicle, I have to do a rally stage because, well, Obey won the World Rally Championship in 1982 and 1984, so it only seems right. And this seems like a pretty decent place to do it, the forests on the north tip of the island. Right, first up is the Tailgater. All-wheel drive. This should do relatively well. That's a big jump. Now, I should say, a rally car has never been this heavy, or this long, or this wide. and yet it is dealing with this very narrow, very technical rally stage. Oh, absolutely brilliantly, to put it mildly. Oh, and the suspension ain't that bad either for dealing with 2 tons of car landing these heavy jumps. Speaking of jumps, it's incredible. And the turn, once you get onto the tarmac, is excellent. The traction on any surface is simply astonishing. Turn in. There you go. It's just that easy. Even heading up this hairpin, no problem whatsoever. Get the back end a little bit outside the curb on the inside of the curb. Whatever. And now we're heading twisties into the mountains. And this is where it starts to get tricky because there's no runoff area like that. Whoa, actually got a bit of oversteer there. That's a little bit surprising, but we deal with it with ease. Whoa, just power through it, and you'll be fine. Yeah, I'm liking how the Obey deals with this stage. I mean, you can see it, that their all-wheel drive system, which originated in that rally car you saw earlier, the Omnis, it's still there. It still feels like a brilliant car. It's not very quick. I think we're going 40 miles an hour, but it is damn controllable. It is super controllable. And I really, really like that. We only have a few more corners left to go. We have a two-wheel moment. Right. I can see the finishing line. Just gotta get around this hairpin. Handbrake, there you go. Chuck it in. Proper rally car slide. And across the line. Not bad. Not bad for a four-door sedan, for sure. But let's see if its two-door cousin will be an event. And we're off. Significantly more acceleration in this vehicle. It is almost 300 pounds lighter, and it has more power with all-wheel drive. This thing is freaking quick. And it's wider, which is, I'm not sure that's a benefit here, I will be honest, but that does mean technically it gives it significantly better handling. Although the suspension isn't quite as refined, shall we say. It's good, it's still dealing with this bumps surprisingly well. That's 100 miles an hour on a rally stage. Holy crap. It certainly is out of its element, shall we say, the 8F. Ooh! That was a lot more air time than we got in the tailgater. Holy crap. That was fast. We're spitting many of flames. What was that? Two-wheel shenanigans. I mean, the center of gravity is not very high in this car, but the grip sometimes results in grip roll. Whoa, bit of oversteer. This is a terrifying vehicle to drive. Let's not slide off the cliff there. That would be extremely disappointing. Big jump. Don't go that way. Don't go that way. Don't go that way. No. Whoa. Jesus, nearly fell off the cliff again in the 8F here. Jesus. Ooh. We're about 3/4 of the way done. Oh, come on, car. Come on. We're almost at the top of the mountain. Almost at the top. I can't wait for this to be done, to be honest. Woo. Nope, don't spin around there. That's where the Obey with the tailgater spun last time. Now, chuck it in, don't slide off the edge, that was close. We only got a few more corners left, thank the Lord. Now chuck it in, there you go. Down the hill, we got one more hairpin to go, come on. Chuck it in, handbrake, there you go, flick, flick. And we are across the line. That was not fun. I'm gonna need a minute. That made me sick. No matter how terrifying it was to drive, though, the end result is that it was 11 seconds faster on the stage. And that's a lot of time on a 2-minute rally stage. and it has a faster top speed and a faster 0-60. So, this is one heck of a car, if you're willing to have the guts and the bravery to conquer it.